If you've ever baked anything, you may have noticed that vanilla extract is a pretty common ingredient in many desserts. Around the world, the production of vanilla is about 2,000 tons. But most of the vanilla-flavored food products you find at the store don't actually contain natural vanilla. In fact, the demand of vanilla greatly exceeds the amount of natural vanilla that is actually produced due to its labor-intensive production process. In addition to this, natural vanilla is the second most expensive spice in the world. Hence, scientists began to synthesize vanillin in order to fulfill the consumer demand with a cheaper vanilla alternative. Vanillin is only one of the many flavor components that occur in natural vanilla beans. Meanwhile, imitation vanilla extract consists purely of vanillin. The origin of synthetic vanillin can be traced back to two German scientists, Ferdinand Tiemann and Wilhelm Harman, in 1874. They figured out the chemical structure of vanillin. Originally, synthetic vanillin was synthesized with eugenol from clove oil, then from lignin, a byproduct of wood pulp, in paper production. In current times, most synthetic vanillin is synthesized from the petrochemical guaiacol and glyoxylic acid. Vanillin can even be synthesized from castoreum, which is a secretion that comes from the anal glands of beavers. But this is a pretty uncommon source. Synthetic vanillin became widely available in the 1930s, and by 1981, a pulp and paper mill in Ontario, Canada, became the supplier of 60% of the world's synthetic vanillin. Vanillin, also known by its official IUPAC name, 4-hydroxy-3-methoxybenzaldehyde, is a fragrant aromatic compound, which is obvious from the benzene ring. Its chemical properties consist of hydrophobicity due to benzene, strong inter- and intramolecular forces due to the ether and aldehyde functional groups, as well as hydrogen bonding in the hydroxy. It also has high reactivity due to the polar carbonyl group. As for the chemical synthesis of vanillin from guaiacol, it is a two-step process. First, guaiacol undergoes an electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction with glyoxylic acid. This creates vanillyl mandelic acid, which is then oxidized into 4-hydroxy-3-methoxy-phenylglyoxylic acid. After that is oxidative decarboxylation, which finally produces the vanillin we've been looking for. You may be wondering, why would someone choose imitation vanilla extract over the natural kind? Isn't it always better to avoid artificial food products? Well, you're not alone in thinking that. Due to the sustainability movement, the consumer demand for all things natural has skyrocketed. In around 2015, Nestle pronounced that in the US, they would no longer include artificial additives in their chocolate, which includes synthetic vanillin. However, that year, the vanilla harvesting season in Madagascar was a complete failure. All of these factors combined led the price of natural vanilla to increase to over $11,000 per kilogram. I don't know about you, but that's definitely over my budget. Other than the cost-effectiveness of imitation vanilla extract, to bakers, it may be the preferred choice, depending on the circumstance. The many flavor components of natural vanilla don't usually survive high temperatures, so they're better to use in things like puddings that cook at a lower temperature. Therefore, for things like cookies or cakes, which are baked at much higher temperatures, artificial vanilla takes the point and will result in a finished product with a more intense vanilla flavor. So whether your vanillin comes from South America or a lab, you can rest assured that you won't be missing out on the warm aroma and familiar flavor in all of your favorite desserts.